Hi, I'm Katie Webster, and I'm here with Dan Laren.
Hello.
And today things are a little bit different. We are actually in Dan's office, where he spends the majority of his working time,
I this guess. This is where we are.
You would say. We're going to talk about one of Dan's cases today. Right, Dan?
I've got a case that I recently resolved. This was a DUI case that was made worse by some poor decisions that were made by the defendant in this case. DUI is a pretty serious thing for us. And we don't do a lot of DUI work in circuit court. Most of this happens in district court. But this particular case, it was last May, about 1:30, 1:45 in the morning. Young lady was at a bar not too far from downtown and got angry at her boyfriend. Decided that it would be a good idea to take his vehicle so that he couldn't use it to pick up other girls and drive the vehicle home. Unfortunately, she was under the influence and she missed a turn, and she literally parked her vehicle in the victim's home. The victim was a lady who lives in the downtown area, woke up about 2 o'clock in the morning to find a car parked inside her living room. She went down to see who the driver was. The driver was not injured. Her name was Jessica Halverson. She was 25 years old at the time. There's Miss Halverson. The police and the fire department responded to the scene, pulled the vehicle out of the house, and the police administered the field sobriety test. Miss Halverson flunked them all. She was arrested, charged with DUI and wanton endangerment. She went to the jail, and her breathalyzer result was .185, which is, you're well aware, is over twice the legal limit here in Kentucky. So those were the facts of the case. Mm-hmm. Ms. Halverson came to us in circuit court. The grand jury indicted her for wanton endangerment and DUI. She tried to negotiate for a better offer. I was not inclined to do that. I went out to the house and talked to the lady whose home it was. I stood in the living room where this car had been parked last May, and I just decided that it wasn't a case that deserved a lot of consideration. Ms. Halverson had a history of really only traffic offenses, a lot of driving without insurance, which people don't think a lot about that until you get hit by somebody who doesn't have insurance, or like this case, park your car in somebody's living room when you don't have insurance. So that was an issue. Fortunately for the victim, her home insurance covered the damages in this case. Ms. Halverson pled guilty to wanton endangerment and DUI. She was sentenced to 2 years. She was put on probation for 5 years and ordered to serve 100 days in the county jail. While the case was ongoing, she was arrested twice for new traffic violations, driving without a license, driving without insurance, and is, as we speak, still serving her 100 days in the jail. So that's a case where a bad decision was made worse by this young lady's decision not to only drive while intoxicated, but to park her car in the victim's house.
Good work, Dan. There's a lesson to be learned from this. There are there, better ways to keep your boyfriend
from other women. There are a number of lessons to be learned here, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Well, thanks for talking to us.
Anytime.
Well, from Dan's office, this is Case of the Week.